years ago when I was doing the NAM, got approached by a number of college organizations talking about using the NAM as a tool for teaching about the Vietnam War, which was something that was not done then. And it's something I sort of promote because I believe that any kind of reading, be it comic books or novels or whatever, is better than staring blindly at TV. Of course, I don't necessarily mean all comic books because there are some companies downstairs. I don't think you have to know how to read to buy, but I can get into that right now.
As a buyer and a clerk at the bookstore, I come across two different types of teachers, the kinds who only look at the cover of a comic book, which is the inside of the book, and there's some that are very enthusiastic about it and see them as like the future instead of getting these kids to read. I also see, especially in our junior fiction section, which is like the age group where most mainstream comics are geared for anyway, that there's a severe lack of good stories for boys. It's like the Hardy Boys, and there's a few that won Newbery Awards and so forth, but most of those have taken place long in the past. It's very difficult for today's kids to relate to them. The only reason for doing anything. First, we just got to get them to read, even if they just read crap, you know. And then eventually, I used to read just crap, and then I gravitated towards the good stuff. I think just out of curiosity, who your guys are educators and parents? Okay. Parents put your hands up, it's just the educators.
Okay. What I'm trying to do is I'm trying to make an academic career in comics, so to me, comics in the classroom is the college classroom. As part of the Comic Card Collection, and I've got flyers up here, we archive papers written by students, professors, that sort of thing. We're building a collection of syllabi for college classes. And one of the things that I'm trying to promote in my comic arts conference, I have a newsletter and so forth, is the use of comics in the various disciplines. I'm hoping to get Scott's book, Understanding Comics, introduced into a number of art departments, that sort of thing. And I've taught popular culture. We use The Killing Joke as part of that, and a friend of mine used The Dark Knight in that same class. And comics are really useful at the college level for a number of reasons. For the second reasons, they're obviously useful for primary and secondary education, but there's a lot of stuff that they can be used for. They can be used in any number of different classes, and they lend themselves to an interdisciplinary approach. You can use them in history. English, you can use them in art, whatever. A class that I'm teaching now called American World, it's 1492 to 1992, 15 weeks, I didn't think of that. I'm putting together a list of comics that can go along with it. Like, we start out with Columbus coming over to America, and so Alvar Mayer, Death and Silver, for instance, is a good historical comic.